guys, it's Aldo at Kixie here. So today I want to show you how you can use a HubSpot workflow to track your marketing sources based on Kixie phone numbers that are being dialed. So the use case here is that you have different ad sources out there, different marketing channels, and each one has its own unique Kixie phone number. You're basically using these Kixie phone numbers to keep track of which ads are working best based on the number of times a given phone number is being dialed. So we can actually create a HubSpot workflow that helps you keep track of all of this automatically. So let's jump inside of HubSpot right now and we'll take a look at this workflow right here. And so a lot of this has to do with the way that Kixie actually logs a phone call into HubSpot. It gets logged as a call activity. And the Kixie phone number that's being dialed is included in the notes section of the call that gets logged. So what that means is that we can actually build a trigger and we can use call notes as the criteria for the trigger. So over here I have call notes contains incoming because it's an incoming call. I only want the incoming calls and a given phone number that I use. And this is one of my Kixie phone numbers and I can generate as many as I need for different initiatives. So in this workflow, I actually have two different phone numbers that are being used. You can create one, consolidate all of these into one workflow or have different workflows for different phone numbers. They both work for the sake of this. I'm just consolidating them all. So you can see that I have two different triggers here. If somebody calls this phone number, and we'll say this is for like Facebook ads that I'm running, this workflow will kick off, or if they call this phone number. And I'll show you how I can actually add one of these. So I'll click or over here because this is a third trigger. And I'll go to activity properties and I'll type in notes and I'm going to select call notes. So if call notes contains any of incoming, apply filter. And then I'll scroll down here and click and because this is a second criteria that I want to add to this third trigger. And if it contains a new Kixie phone number, let me pull one over here. Call notes contains any of this phone number, apply filter. Now I have a third trigger where it's incoming calls to a new phone number. I'll click save. So the next step is to use the HubSpot set property value action to actually plug in a new marketing source. Because I have three different phone numbers here, I want to use an if-then branch to help me make sure that I'm plugging in the right marketing source for the right phone number. So the if-then branch looks like this. And basically we'll say, we'll pretend the first phone number was for Facebook. And so if it has this phone number in the call note, then it goes down branch A. And if it has this phone number in the call note, it goes down branch B. And I'll click add another branch here. And let's pretend that this third phone number was for a Craigslist ad that I'm running. So I'll do Craigslist and the phone number. So this is the name of my new branch. And then I'll create the criteria for this branch, call notes, contains any of incoming, and it contains this phone number. Apply filter. Whoops, I'm actually gonna trash can this. It should be and. Craigslist. Call notes contains any of incoming. Apply filter. I'll come down here really quick. And it contains the phone number. Perfect. Great. So now I have a new branch for my Craigslist ad where it's an incoming call to this phone number. And I'll click save. So now I've added my new phone number into the logic tree here, but I want to actually make sure that I'm updating the marketing source field on the contact record to show my new ad source, Craigslist here. So I'll click the little plus sign right below the branch and I'll use set property value. Click, and the property that I want to set is marketing source. This is actually a custom field that I created and I just made it text-based so that it's more flexible. I could just write in the name of any ad source here. And I'll type in Craigslist. So now I'm basically telling HubSpot, when this third phone number is dialed, I want you to populate the marketing source field to say Craigslist. and I can create like a custom report in my reporting section based off of these different marketing fields. So that way I can sort of keep better track of which ones are working best. And so this is really the entire workflow. We have triggers where you're looking at the phone number that's being dialed, and then you're sorting out the phone numbers and you're updating a property value, like a marketing source. It could be whatever you want to call it, to actually reflect the marketing source that was dialed for that given contact. And so this is a pretty easy way to keep track of your marketing efforts using Kixie with HubSpot workflows. If you have any questions, let us know, or any other ideas as to workflows that you might kicked off based off a specific phone number being dialed. Would love to hear about that in the comments section, and stay tuned for more. Thanks.